I'm back in the what they call the smoker's patio at the Gallivan Center with the guys from Bear Hands. Dylan, we spoke on the phone just a little bit ago.
Yeah, very
not
recently.
Like today.
No, but recently.
Yeah. Uh-huh. And then Val, nice to meet you officially. Let's do it with a handshake.
Nice to meet you too.
We're kicking it here backstage at the Big Ass Show, and you guys made a comment right before we got started that it's been a while since you've played together.
Yeah.
I mean, you guys practiced a couple nights the last week, but
yeah, but I wasn't even there. So we played a show in Kansas City a month ago.
Okay.
And then I live in Los Angeles, and the rest of the band lives in New York, so we weren't able to practice. So they practiced together, and then I did a little solo practice, you know, like singing in the shower.
I'll see how that goes.
Yeah, I love it. You're like, all right, tell me what time you guys are going to start at.
Right, I'll be there.
I'm going to go ahead and start in my place. You guys start there too.
Yeah.
FaceTime.
Right, exactly.
Too much lag.
You just have to believe that the sound is happening 3,000 miles away, you know?
How hard is that for you guys, for the band?
It's been hard. I feel isolated out there a little bit, you know? I mean, I have such a lovely girlfriend who I adore, but...
Is that why you're in LA?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
But you know, it's weird not spending like a lot of quality day-to-day FaceTime with the people in my band, you know?
Yeah.
It's been strange, yeah.
Talk about it, Val. But,
well, yeah, you're used to one thing. We've been a band for 12 years, and he moved about 2 years ago, and
right.
It just changed the whole dynamic. But fly-ins like this are great because just go to the same spot.
And also, it can be enjoyable to not spend every day with each other,
sure.
too. You know?
I was going to say, there's some healthiness about
right,
that.
Right, yeah.
Oh, definitely.
So now when we do get together, then it's like you get to share all the news that has occurred within the past month or whatever.
Catching up.
Right.
And happy to see them.
Right, yeah, and you hate the person less. Sure. It's nice.
I don't know if people can see it, but there's a fly that I've paid to be right in your face. It's not like a thing he's just doing.
Yeah, I'm not crazy.
There is a fly.
Hey, I'm not crazy.
Right in the success of Backseat Driver, I know you guys have an album that we can't talk about when it's coming, but that it is forthcoming. But talk about the album for me.
We made it with this kid, Chris Chu, who was in a band called Morning Benders that became Pop Etc. Now he's producing records, and he's out in L.A. He lives very close to where I live in L.A. So, you know, first we wrote some sketches of songs and, you know, made some demos together.
We went upstate.
To New York, and worked together, and then we took it to Chris in LA and worked out of his bedroom studio, and it's done pretty much.
We would fly out from New York like once a month and work stuff for a few months, and actually came together pretty easily, all things considered.
Yeah, we finished it in the middle of the summer, and we're just
So when do we get it? We don't know.
I think early next year.
So we're gonna say first quarter. Can we?
First quarter.
First quarter.
Yeah.
In all those terms that just sound like not a real thing.
Yeah. Right, yeah.
Oh,
uh-huh.
Yeah, the first quarter.
The first financial quarter.
Oh, yeah, I mean, I feel like that's a great choice. So the being separated, I want to go back. Val, do you send him the text messages that you're like, hey, you can come back. We'd love to have you back here.
Well, I mean, I want to move to LA too, but...
So what's the holdup? Because it seems like one moves, it makes it to go the other way, but is life too much New York?
My girlfriend has a really good job. She works in the music industry as well.
Yeah.
Cool. What's she do?
She does sing some licensing at Beggars Group.
Oh, cool.
There's too many tentacles attaching him to the city, you know? It's like, it's
just
hard. I had way less tentacles when I moved to L.A. You know, I didn't have a girlfriend when I moved to L.A.
Okay.
And, you know, there was just like nothing really grounding me there.
Yeah.
You know, so it was a lot easier for me to go. But I am trying to work on them to get them out to LA. Yeah, I would prefer if they moved out.
My family's from Connecticut and hers is from Philly.
Okay.
So we're like 2 hours.
Sure, close to family and jobs.
And we're both like very close with our family. So that's probably the main reason why I made the jump. But I'm more into it than she is.
Right. So you guys were talking about putting together a set list and that you haven't done it yet for today.
Yeah.
We know which songs. We know what songs, but...
Sure. But you haven't put them in one order.
Right, yeah. Uh-huh.
In case we forget on stage, yeah.
Right, yeah.
How do you figure that out? Like,
usually it's like not really a task that's good for delegation or democracy.
Uh-huh.
So usually we assign it to one person. Usually it's been Val. Like, I'll do it sometimes. It's like, it's a job you give to one person and then, like, no questions asked.
So why depends on
what time you play in the day. Like, you know, if we're playing earlier, so we'll play the songs that people know more.
We'll play the hits later in the set.
Okay.
Yeah, when you play early.
People are walking in the whole time.
Yeah.
If you're playing a headlining set, you can kind of put songs wherever you want because people are there to see you. So just kind of adjust it for whatever crowd you're playing to.
Cool. Mm-hmm. Cool. And Salt Lake loves you guys. Hopefully you love Salt Lake.
We do. Yeah, we really love Salt Lake. Definitely. Kill the court.
Yeah.
Oh my God, I love Kill Decor, you know?
Like you guys would say anything alternately.
No, but it's like that. Kill Decor is like, it's one of the only, it's like one of the only like real venues that you go to. Yeah, that like feels like a DIY like punk flop house, and like that appeals to us.
Well, we're excited to have you guys here playing the 22nd. I can't believe we've done that many.
Wow, congrats.
Show. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, thank you, in this day and age, right?
Definitely.
Yeah. The station kept trying to move to LA, and we're like,
no,
please stay.
Yeah, exactly.
Please stay, we can't handle it.
Be loyal, you know? Yeah. Loyalty, above all.
We can all move out there. But excited to have you guys here, and looking forward to the album in the first quarter of 2019. Thanks, you guys.
Thank you. Thank you.